It is time now for the Rhody Roundup. Yep, it must be Friday. They're ready. We are chatting about some of the headlines making the rounds this week. Right now, let's meet our handsome panel here this morning. Today's co-host, local mom blogger Audrey McClelland is here, local entrepreneur Ed Brady. Hey, buddy. And last but not least, the lovely Amy Ponce from Light Rock 105.
Lovely.
One of our absolute favorites. How's everybody doing today?
Lovely.
Very good.
I like your shoes.
Thanks, buddy. Yeah, it's an Ed Brady sandwich right here is what it is. Let's get right to it. Lots to talk about. A big day. Coldplay, they've been announced. They've got a new album coming out today, and they will be playing the Super Bowl halftime show. So I want to know, what do you guys think of this? Audrey, do you like Coldplay? Do you think it's a good choice?
You know, okay. I know that he was married to Gwyneth Paltrow, and I know he dated Jennifer Lawrence. Done.
And that's it.
That's all I know. I couldn't name a song right now. If you put money down, I would not be able to name a song.
We came up with a few. Ed, do you think this is a good selection?
I think it's a safe choice. I don't think we'll see naked body parts flying around. I can't wait for the Patriots to be there.
Absolutely. I like the way you think. Yeah, sorry, Amy, are you a Coldplay fan?
Yeah, I've seen Coldplay in concert. They put on a fantastic show. A show, you know what I mean? Not just going on and singing. A nice show. So I think they're a good choice for halftime. And hopefully he bring some of the people that he collaborates with on stage with him.
Yeah. Honestly, it's in San Francisco. That's the hometown of my favorite band, Metallica. I really think they should have been for halftime entertainment. I'm going to start a letter writing campaign that will go nowhere. Moving on here, guys. Someone else having a big week. Rhode Island native Viola Davis just honored by Ebony Magazine as one of the Power 100. She's on that list, and she is the on the cover of the January edition of In Style. There she is, looking quite
gorgeous on the cover of In Style.
She's fantastic. We'll start this way this time. Amy, you will lead us off. What do you think of this? Do you like her? She's terrific.
I love her. I love having a powerful woman from Rhode Island that, having two young daughters, can look up to. And it just makes me proud.
Sure.
I love when our Rhode Islanders represent big things.
Well, you really hit on something there. It's nice for the young girls to have a role model like that. She does such positive things for her community, for all of us here in Rhode Island, which is great. And Ed, I mean, when you see something like this happening, do you agree?
Oh, I love it. I mean, Rhody proud. I mean, Central Falls girl, obviously, Miss Rhode Island's from Central Falls, great young mayor over there. It's great to see that for our state. I'm definitely a How to Get Away with Murder fan.
Yeah.
I watch about two shows on TV, The Road Show and How to Get Away with Murder. So,
Oh, he knows how to get invited back.
So
doesn't he? And Audrey, when you see something like this, I mean, first of all, are you a Viola Davis fan? And do you love stuff like this?
I love it. That's like the one show, too, that I will watch every week that I don't DVR. I actually watch it live.
Right.
And then, I mean, as a business owner, like, you know, I'm an entrepreneur myself.
Yep.
And to see someone, you know, kind of take a different path and to go out there, and it's tough, and you got to work and a lot of hustling, and to see that come of it, that is pretty amazing. It's inspiring.
It really is remarkable to see it all happening. And our final topic here today, we're opening with you, sir, on this one, because this is an Instagram related topic.
Okay.
And you, sir, are the king of Instagram selfies. He does
it
in a tasteful way. It has been announced that hashtag love, say it with me, folks, love is the most used hashtag on Instagram. That was for 2015. Now, love has been the top hashtag for 3 years running on the social media site. So do you like hashtags? Do you use them? Do you find yourself using love, Ed?
Yeah, I mean, I definitely think it's important from a marketing branding standpoint to use hashtags, get it out there. Love, very positive. That's a benefit of using that word. I would think Latergram or Foodie or something along the line, Thirsty Beaver RI would possibly be a bigger one. But just throwing some of those out there, Milk Money RI, you know. But
either way,
I think it's very positive and cool. Love is in the air.
You know,
it's a holiday season.
Hashtag Roadshow. Hashtag Ed Brady. Audrey, what do you think? I know you use a lot of social media with your career and your family. What do you think of this?
Well, I saw this study, and I actually went to the Gap, bought a love hat yesterday, and I hashtag love, so
love
I could be in the top searches on Instagram. Yeah, I love hashtags. It's a way of life for me. It's a way, like, you know, obviously Ed said, it's business, marketing. It's a great tool to use. So I love seeing something like Ed said, powerful love as the top one. That's great.
And last but not least, batting third here, Amy, what do you think?
It's true. And everything they just said, and it's a simple thing too. It's like, what can I hashtag love? That's fine. Even if it's like, you
works
know,
for everything.
A terrible, you know, a tree fell or something. Love.
But I'm thinking of you, and I want to see things get better.
Yes, everything was okay. Yeah.
I love the humble brag, blessed. Come on, you're just showing off. Well, that's what's happening this week. Audrey, thank you. Ed, a pleasure. And speaking of love, Amy, always good to see you. Thank you.
God bless you and your family.
Hashtag love.
That's right. That's how we do the roundup. Still to come this morning. Thank you so much for